Hey guys, SuperHorrorBro Mike here, and in today's video, we are revisiting the original Little Nightmares. I thought as Little Nightmares 2 is coming out in a few months, it would be a good time to go back to the original game that started it all, play through it on the channel, and obviously, this will probably be, I imagine, like a 3 or 4 part playthrough for the sort of main game, and then if you guys want to see me do the DLC as well, if this series performs quite well, we will go back and also cover that, so we're all up to date and refreshed on the story of the first game and its side story before the next one comes out. And I think that would be quite a good idea. So the next few Let's Plays on the channel are going to be a revisit of Little Nightmares, and let's start today with a new game. Let's overwrite my gameplay here, I guess, and start. So here we have the lady, of course. Six's vision of her nemesis, who she will finally face off against later in the game, and sort of the main antagonist of this game, I suppose. Then Six wakes up, and this is actually really interesting. If you guys have watched my playthrough of Very Little Nightmares, you'll realize that Six actually inherited the raincoat from another child and sort of was washed into the sea on a raft, and then made her way obviously to the moor, where she got sort of stranded, I guess, and she's been hiding in the walls of a moor ever since escaping the nest in Very Little Nightmares, which was like the mobile game, which was actually quite cool. I've done theories and a whole like story analysis of that if you want to go and check it out, guys, but that's just some backstory. So Six has woken up aboard the moor where she's got stranded in the middle of the ocean, and she now needs to find a way off. So yeah, let's sort of head on through. Can hear those gnomes just kind of scrambling about in front of us. Here we go. Let's light these little lamps as we go as well. There we go, one lamp down and many more to go. All right, let's open up this bad boy. There we go, and through into the darkness ahead. I love the atmosphere of Little Nightmares games. It's just unlike anything else, really. It's really, really cool. I can hear my surroundings just creaking as we obviously are beneath the ocean waves at the moment, in the depths of the ocean. Okay, let's head on up the stairs. So high up. I would not like this. I have a fear of heights. So this would not be good for me personally. But obviously Six is pretty brave by the look of it. We've also got these like little statues, guys. You can see the statue here. If I pick this up and throw it, it will break, and you can actually get, like, I did a video like a long time ago covering like where all of those are if you want to get the trophy for it if you're playing on console, or the Steam achievement, I guess, as well on Steam. You can follow my guide there. Lots of cigarettes here. I don't know why they would just dump cigarettes on their sofa. I guess I don't really care too much about the upholstery, but yeah, not good for the upkeep of that sort of leather. Let's go through here. And here we have like this crazy sight to behold. There's this sort of note down here, which is probably a suicide note from this guy who seems to be hanging up here. And we've actually done a video recently, a theory video, guys. There's a new character in Little Nightmares 2 called the Thin Man, and he looks very, very much like this Hanging Man here. So if you want to sort of know my theory as to the connection between these two characters and them possibly being one and the same, just go and check that video out. But for now, we're just going to ignore this guy, and we're going to pull this chair over to the door, because of course we need to use that to get out of here. Don't want to be looking at some hanging man. Got some slime down there, some oil, and some big footprints, much bigger than Six's. Some big handprints as well. There we go. We've got a little gnome. As you can see, if we run this way, we can actually make our way through this little hole in the wall and go and find a gnome. And you can actually hug these gnomes. I think you get an achievement if you hug all of them, but I could be wrong there. You can light this lamp at least. And I think that's really cute. You see the little gnome there just like warming his hands on the lamp. But if we go over to him, we can actually interact with him, give him a little hug. That's just pretty adorable, if you ask me. That's pretty cute. Let's keep going. get back to that fridge. We need to climb up that. So here we are. One fridge for climbing. Up we go. There we go. Nice. I don't like how this ship is like leaking as well. You can see water coming out of everything. If I was beneath the ocean waves. Oh wait, what's that? It's a leech. We've got to go. We've got leeches, guys. And these leeches are very, very, like, dangerous. They can one-hit kill us. So we need to make sure that we are not letting them catch us up. What do we do here? Can we push through this door? Oh, no, there's a switch. I completely did not see that switch then. We've got an elevator. Man, we need to... Ah, there you go. Need to make a long jump there. There you go. Pull these boards out of the way. Oh. Cute little gnome there. No. We're in the slime. And there's leeches all over. Okay. Go, 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 go. I forgot you can't run through the slime and I was just like casually walking there. Quick. Six. Go. Man, that was close. Right, I don't think leeches can jump unless they've got some kind of Olympic gold medalist leech there, so we should be safe now. I'm going to keep lighting these. We don't really need to light these for the story or for any, you know, kind of a special reason. I think you maybe unlock a mask if you unlock them all, but there's another little gnome. But yeah, we'll just light the ones we see, you know, for the fun of it, I guess. But yeah, it's really fun to be back in this world, guys. I haven't played the original Little Nightmares start to finish in, like, at least 6 months or so. But it is one of my favourite horror games, I think. It's just really well designed. A lot of character, really creepy. Definitely excited for the sequel. But what is that noise? There's some kind of creepy-ass noise going on. The howling wind. I remember this. This puzzle, guys, we have to, like, I think we have to start this up, and then we have to, like, run to that door over there. We have to do this massive leap of faith here. So let's go. And I think we have to do a slide as well. I can't remember how to slide. I think it's this button. Yeah, there we go. We're very lucky there. I could have got cut in two by that door. Wait a second. Can we open this? This looks like it's openable. No, we can't. Maybe you can, I just can't seem to open that. I'll go this way. Man, what is that? Look there, the jailer. Is the janitor, I think, isn't he? Roger the janitor, that's his name. I think a lot of people originally when this game came out would call him the jailer because he does kind of jail the kids, but he is known as the janitor officially. He does a bit of jailing and a bit of janitoring and a little bit of kind of packaging children up, which is kind of weird. He does a bit of everything in this game, does old Roger. Here we go, we'll light that lamp. Keep with the lighting the lamp theme. Nice big rat there. Never been a huge fan of rats myself. I quite like hamsters. Gerbils, mice, but rats kind of freak me out a little bit. Probably going to aggro quite a lot of people in chat now because I know a lot of people really like rats as pets, but not me. I kind of always see them as just dirty like creatures. I don't really have any affinity for them. Right, we got to run now, guys. We've got to find a way to get back through this room, this kind of creepy-ass playroom here. And through this fence before it turns back on. And we made it. You'll see it power on in a second and it'll become electrified. There you go. Let's keep heading on and see what we find next. We've got some little building blocks here and you'll notice these building blocks actually, if we turn the lighter on, you'll see that they all have like little eye symbols on. And of course these eye symbols are synonymous with the world of Little Nightmares, the voyeurism in this world, and probably all tie back to the signal tower. But of course we're going to see in the second game that Mono and Six are heading towards in the sequel. Hopefully we can shut that down. Oh, we've got an eye. We've got an eyeball. Now this will actually turn us to stone like those kids are there. If we let it sort of lay eyes on us, so to speak. So we need to move quickly. You can see over there, we've actually got a gnome, as you can see, like, in the mouth of that cage. So we'll head over to see him in a second. I really don't know why I'm lighting all of these lamps, because we're not going for 100% on them. It's just kind of an addiction I've got now. Right, let's drop down. As you can see, here's another little secret area. You can head through here and see that this gnome is actually looking at some pictures of his fellow gnomes. There's obviously a terrible secret, which I won't spoil quite yet. If you're going to watch my DLC playthrough, you don't want it spoiled, but there is a terrible secret behind these gnome characters and their origins. Actually, wait. We should hug that guy, right? We should hug the gnome. There you go, little fella. Hopefully that brings a smile to your face and a little bit of joy to your day in such a desolate and miserable place as the moor. Need to reclimb this now. All the way up these cages. It's another thing I really like about Little Nightmares is like how the environments feel so naturalistic. Like, obviously stuff like that is a mechanic for climbing up, but it feels like it's just part of the environment. And it's that kind of, I don't know, that naturalism that I think just shows how great this game is design-wise, you know. We've got another statue here, let's chuck that. And as you can see up here, we've got another one of those eye symbols, and it just goes to show that the eyes are everywhere, they're watching everything here in this world. We've got drawings of the eyes there, we've got like a drawing of what could well be the Thin Man from Little Nightmares 2 there. We've got a drawing of Six there, strangely enough. And I have done a theory on why she might appear in these drawings, which you can find on the channel. I should really start a Little Nightmares playlist at this point because I've done quite a few videos on it over the past sort of year and a half or so. And it'd be nice to have them all in one place, I think, especially with the advent of this playthrough as well. Oh, okay. We need to hide. Hello there, Roger. Like, looking really, really great. You look healthy, man. Oh, that'd be so... Imagine being one of the kids asleep in these beds, right? Just having to witness this guy, like, creeping around at night, like, making sure you haven't got out of bed. Like, that's just the stuff of nightmares right there. See you later, Roger. Just, yeah, there you go. Off you pop. Nice. So yeah, as you can see, guys, in all of these beds, we've got the kids just sleeping, right? These are all sort of children that have been stolen, snatched up by the people running the moor. And it's almost like a kind of twisted nursery, isn't it? You can see they're just kind of like wriggling in their beds. Nobody knows exactly why, but they are definitely being used as a product in this world, potentially being fed to people that visit the moor even. Pretty disturbing stuff. Let's venture on. We've got a little air vent here we can crawl through. Can hear that wind howling. Right, here we go, guys. We've dropped down. There's the rat again. The least of our worries right now. Ooh. Something's up. We need some food. Our stomach is rumbling. Could really go for some spaghetti bolognese right now. Or a pizza. I do love Italian food, you know? It's probably what would... You know, that would be my pick right now. A nice... pizza, maybe some garlic bread, some chicken wings. Ooh. And here we can see the little kid just kind of watching us. And some people have kind of wondered, I think, could this be, you know, perhaps a mono from the new game even? I don't know about that, but it does make us wonder. maybe everything does tie together, but whoever that person is, they've given us a little bit of bread to chew on, and that has restored our well-being, our health, and we're all good to go again. So yeah, like, thanks for the bread, it's much appreciated, kind stranger. I had my own thoughts on who this person could be. I wondered if it was maybe the girl from the original game that you play as, Very Little Nightmares. I say the original game, the prequel to this game on mobile, who seems to disappear into the sea and die, but maybe, I don't know, she made it to the moor as well. But yeah, we don't know who that is. It's just some random kid, probably. But there are, of course, theories on it. Now we need to reach that noose. As you can see, there's this like long noose hanging from the ceiling, but we're not going to be able to reach it from this room. So we're going to have to venture onward into this shower room, which, you know, I'm guessing this is where the kids like get to bathe and wash. Looks a bit cold. It looks like you could easily catch a chill there. Not really an inviting shower room, is it? We can't get through this fence yet. You see, I think the noose that we're looking to grab hold of is what turns the electric off for that fence. So in order to do that, we're going to need to get up to the noose, which means climbing all these cages. I would not like this. As I said, my fear of heights, really don't get on with heights. So this would be kind of like my ultimate nightmare, being up this high. No safety harness in place. Just don't look down, Six. We'll be alright. Okay, so we've lit that. What do we do now? Maybe run to that? Can we make that? Yes, we did. Nice. And now climb the chain? Yes, I remember. I wasn't too sure. Like, there are parts of this game I don't remember so much, even though I've played it a long time. I don't know how many hours now. But yeah, like, some parts I haven't played in a long while. We don't want to jump from too much of a height because we might die, but I think this should be okay. There you go. Nice. Here we go. She's quite a nimble little thing. Right. So, do I grab this first? Yes. We need to bring up the cage. I remember. And when we need to swing it all the way to the left and then back. And we should be able to jump to it. So here we go. But of course we need to get it started going back to the left before we jump to it. Jump. Oh no, guys! That was such a bad fall as well. I can't believe we missed that. Like, I didn't actually, I made it distance-wise, but obviously while we made it distance-wise, I didn't make it kind of like, I didn't line it up enough, so we just jumped completely to the left. And this is one of the only issues I had with this game when it originally released, is that like sometimes the perspective can make it hard to judge your jumps. But obviously, guys, you don't want to watch me get all the way back to that, so I'm going to cut back to where we have got back to that point, and hopefully we can make the jump on our second attempt. All right, guys, attempt number two. Here we go. We're going to bring it back to the right. When it comes back this way, we're going to bring it back to the left. Now we're going to run and hopefully jump. Yay, we made it. So we actually did it that time. I wondered if it was going to stop then. But I think we'll be all right. Here we go. And we made it. Nice. So we actually did it on our second attempt, which is good. And now we need to reach this lever up here in order to get through the electrified sort of gate at the end of the room. So which of these drawers will pull out? This one does. That's good. That one does. So that's also good. That should give us enough height. There we go. And let's jump. Like I said, Six is very nimble. I would not be able to do that if I was her size. Ooh, there's a light. And there's a little gnome as well in this cage. Let's free him. There you go, little fella. Be free, be free. Now, I could go and hug him, but I don't really want to hug every gnome. I'm going to just push that down there. And we're going to be on our way. Here we go. Into the depths. Hopefully, we don't fall off, because it's a long way down. Yay! So we've now powered off the gate at the end of this sort of room, but obviously, because the lights are out, of course we've got leeches everywhere trying to get us. So we better just run. Made it. Nice. Oh, we've got another light. Another eye, sorry. Just hide, hide, hide. Stay low. We're gonna have to move with this sort of mop and bucket. Okay. Go six, go six, go six, go six, go six. Oh, we made it. Okay, good. Right. Nice. That was very close. Oh, and this is okay. This is happening. Did not expect that. Okay, I'm going to climb up this, guys. I think this is the only way out. Ooh, that was close. That was very, very close. The heck is that noise? Oh, it's just the exit opening up. Good. Wow. Okay, so we made it through the first area of the game. Not too bad. Not too shabby. I believe that's the first chapter done. But I do know the point that I would like to get up to before the end of this video, because I kind of know, like, I kind of know the length of this game and, like, good points to finish on for each episode. So I'm going to play on a little longer to get up to a certain point for this video. So let's climb up these stairs. We've got this room here. What's this all about? I always find it really cool how, like, the furniture is sized in this game. It's, like, really odd abstract shapes. Like, you can see this chair is obviously, like, really small, and then the desk is really high. And obviously that could well be because of, like, the way characters are shaped in this world. But I also think a lot of it is coming from the signal tower and the way it distorts this world, as we found out through information for Little Nightmares 2. And I think it just distorts everything in this world into weird shapes, which is kind of cool. Because the thing I do like about Little Nightmares 2 so far is it seems to really add a lot to the lore of the original game and everything we see here. Now, in this room, if we pull this chair, I believe, to this tile over here, we should get... There you go. We get, like, an extra little secret here. And this is actually really cool. Like, if we go through here, we can find this sort of giant eyeball. And as I said before, the eyes really represent the voyeurism of this world. I do want to, like, find the gnome that's in this room as well. Oh, he's going to run out. Okay, well, we'll find him in a second. But yeah, like, the eyes represent the voyeurism in this world, and if we press this button down... So if you have a look here, guys, we can press it again. You can see here we're seeing some gnomes in their little hiding place. Then we've got the chef's quarters, which we will get to later in the game. It's a very creepy area. And then you can actually see the lady's residence, which, again, another area later on in the game. And there is the lady herself. Just casually, like, sat there, twiddling with her hair. And it makes us wonder who is using this room to spy on everyone. And what I believe is that this, as I said earlier in the video, that these eyes represent what the signal tower sees. The signal tower, whoever's controlling that broadcast, is just spying on everyone in this world, and I just find that really interesting, really cool. But there you go, guys, that is everything you can see through that eye. Just gives you a preview of everything to come in the game, which is really cool. We're going to head on up, though, of course, and have a look at what lies ahead for us. Little gnome. Still running from us, still scared. You don't need to be scared. Here you go. How nice is that, right? You get a little hug out of it. And now he's quite happy. Look, now he's friendly. He'll follow me about. He likes us, you know? Okay, that's so cute. Like, just running after us now. He doesn't want to go up the stairs. He knows that there's something bad lying at the top of these stairs. He's like, I'm out. Have a good life. And here we have, I think this is like Roger's quarters. This is why everything is so tall, because he's got such long arms. He can just reach up for all these drawers. Extra space for him, really, isn't it? Like, you look at all these drawers, he can store his pants and his socks in there. We're gonna need this suitcase, I think, to reach that lever up there. There we are. He's got one of those fold-away beds. I've never really been a fan of the look of those. Kind of looks like they wouldn't be too comfy to sleep on, right? You can see that we have the key there. That's what we need to get to. He's got a lot of pictures of gnomes in his room as well. And actually there, you can see this is the staircase that leads out of the game at the very end of the game. So it's interesting they put that there as a sort of precursor to that. Oh, we made it. Now have a look up here, guys. You can actually see at the top of this little shelf, there's another one of these statues. So just chuck that down there. And there you go. I don't know why six jumped as well, but never mind. Let's chuck the key down to the bottom floor. Jump to the bed to break our fall. And now we can actually sort of push through here. Collect up our key. And I think there's a little door that we need to put this into at the other side of this wall. She's so small, she actually has to, like, throw the key up there just in order to climb it. There we are. Another door down. Another puzzle solved. Little monkey here. These symbol monkeys are really freaky. Of course, we see those in the game Dark Deception, but they've always scared me. I never know why kids would want those as a toy. I mean, I don't think any kids playing with those these days, but obviously, in the old days, they were popular, I imagine. I'm gonna take this monkey with us, because I think we might need it to reactivate the elevator here. Got lots of shoes in boxes there. A little too big for six, so I think. Nice. There we go. Going down. Need some elevator music or something to, you know, keep up the mood here. It's too quiet. Here we go. We've got some, some hunger again. We need some food. Let's see if we can find some scraps down here for six before she gets too hungry. I don't know what would happen if her hunger takes over, but we do get to see, like, there's this shadow version of six, which I'll try and show you in a minute, guys. But every time she gets hungry and she goes to eat something, we see the shadow version of her, like her evil side or her dark side. And I don't know, that maybe if she gets too hungry and ravenous, obviously that darkness just takes over. I'm trying not to spoil future events of the game, so I don't want to say too much in case you haven't seen it. But I, you know, I think that's kind of what it all hints towards, right? Let's go down here. Oh, we've got a nice bit of food in that cage. It looks kind of like the rats have been feeding on it, but I guess stale meat, like rancid meat, is going to have to do because we're very, very hungry. Hopefully we don't get some food poisoning from it. There we go. We've got the food. We're eating it. And if you look up there, look, you can just about see Dark Six up there, Shadow Six up there. the hand comes down and locks us away. Roger has caught us, guys. And I think this is where I'm going to end part one of a video. This is exactly where I wanted to be at. As you can see, he's just laying hands on this cage with his kid on it and taking them away to an unknown location. At least unknown at this time. God help their soul. But this is where I'm going to leave it for today, guys. This has, of course, been part one of Little Nightmares, and it's really cool to return to this game and sort of come back to it years later and play through it for you guys on the channel. So I hope you have been enjoying it. If you enjoy this video, if it's doing well and you want to see the full series on this, we'll continue in part two in a few days' time. And yeah, I will do a full playthrough over the next week or so of Little Nightmares, and then we'll perhaps move into the DLC if you guys want that as well. But thanks for watching today. If you have enjoyed the video, remember to hit the like button, leave me a comment down below, and of course subscribe for more videos just like this one, and I will see you all on the next one.